But yeah, I don't think there was ever a time that I wasn't passionate about knives. Knives sort of carry all this information in them that people just don't even understand at face value. Yeah, it's a knife. It can be used as a weapon. It can be used as a tool. I mean, it's very much just an extension of a human, which is good and bad, for better or worse. But it just carries so much information in history, you know, to religion, to cultural differences, to arts, to science, math, metallurgy. The history of the world is in that knife if you look hard enough. Now, I appreciate the craft of it, you know, and that when you say craft, it's kind of split up because there's some rules that you have to follow. There's math and science you can't ignore to get a performance, you know, that you should be getting out of these knives. And then the other side of it is just pure art. As far as the knives I make and the knives that influence me, they are definitely, without a doubt, works of art. But as much as I can, I try to work it like a kitchen. You know, I have stations in here, and I'm kind of working each station by myself and just sort of trying to do as many tasks that are the same as I can at a time. To get this bar, essentially, we're taking a few different metals and, in so few words, sandwiching them together. So we have alternating layers. If you look really closely, you can see there's hundreds of layers. We're gonna do this reverse tip and close this up. We're gonna make what's called a bird's beak and then close it. And that's gonna make both these black bars come to a point and outline our Damascus. We're starting with a big chunk of metal, and we're gonna move and shape that metal into a knife. What we're doing is we're getting this metal very, very hot, and we're gonna be close to forge welding temperatures because the bars that we're gonna be forging, which is essentially moving the metal, we're gonna be using different tools, be using a hand hammer, a power hammer, a hydraulic press. The hydraulic press, for example, is 17 tons. If you can imagine how many cars you'd have to stack up to get the weight of 17 tons, that's how much weight is coming down on this knife. I like having endless possibilities now, where I'm not just stuck to the parameters of a bar of steel. I can start with a round ball, I can start with a big square, a rectangle, and I can use different metals that normally would be really, really, really hard to find, or impossible because I'm forge welding my own metal. So yeah, it just opens a lot of doors. It all boils down to what you're passionate about. Some people are really into hunting, they wanna make hunting knives, great. You know, I come from a culinary background, and you know, buying a new kitchen knife was always just such a source of joy for me, that's the direction I go in. I guess my interest in knives is just, it never is filled. And the more that I look at it, it's just the deeper you go down that rabbit hole. And to me, there's like this magical sort of thing that comes with someone making it with their own two hands, which I think, you know, when you can make something that looks machined, that you did with these guys, like that's where the magic is. There is a lot of bad knife making on the internet, and a lot of stuff that doesn't even really work. A lot of things that are done just for the video, the content, you know, the likes. You know, who cares if it's a good knife? And there's so much of that now that's why I recommend, you know, people either take classes from good, respected knife makers that have been trained by other good, respected knife makers, or, you know, take classes through the ABS or a metal school or a welding school. Hi, I'm Nate Bonner, and I'm a knife maker.